Hello, B here, and welcome back to Environmental Science. I want you to think of five living organisms on Earth. Where do they live? What do they need to survive? The biosphere includes the areas of the Earth that contain and support all living organisms. Thinking about this definition, what are some of the areas of the Earth that contain and support living organisms? You may think of the ground, the air, and the lakes, oceans, and rivers. This short list includes parts of the other three spheres of the Earth we have already discussed. Before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define the biosphere. Identify the key characteristics of the biosphere. The prefix bio means life, so it is fitting that the biosphere includes all of the areas of the Earth that support and contain living organisms. What is different about the biosphere compared to the other spheres we have studied in this unit is that the biosphere includes parts of the geosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. The biosphere includes the lithosphere, the entire hydrosphere, and the lower layers of the atmosphere. These three systems work together to help support all living organisms of the biosphere. What do you think must be true in order for the Earth to sustain life? Pause the video and make a list in your notes. In order for life to exist on Earth, there needs to be a source of energy, which is the sun. There needs to be liquid water. Temperatures must remain between 10 and 40 degrees Celsius. And necessary materials must be constantly cycled, such as the water cycle and carbon cycle. If you remember back to the first lesson of the course, we discussed the spaceship Earth theory that says that Earth is a closed system. Energy from the sun enters the biosphere, but matter does not enter, and it can't leave. All matter needed must come from within the biosphere, which is why processes such as the carbon cycle and water cycle are so important. All of the water, carbon, and other resources that Earth needs is already present and has been present since the Earth formed. It is impossible to get more of these resources. We can only reuse what we already have through these natural cycles and sustainability efforts. There is another aspect of being a closed system that can have a large effect on the biosphere. As a closed system, when one area of Earth is affected, either negatively or positively, it will have an effect on other areas of the Earth. As a closed system, nothing happens in isolation. For example, the particles from volcanic eruptions can cause acid rain in other parts of the world. The biosphere includes the biotic or living and abiotic or non-living factors in the environment. Examples of abiotic factors include water, carbon dioxide, oxygen gas, and minerals. The biosphere is often broken down and studied by its levels of complexity. The simplest level is the individual. At this level, you have a single organism. When a group of organisms of the same species come together in the same geographic area, you have a population. A group of populations that interact with each other make up a community. And when all of the communities come together, along with the abiotic factors in a particular area, you form an ecosystem. Together, all of the ecosystems on Earth with similar physical characteristics and climate form biomes. And finally, all of the biomes on Earth come together to form the biosphere. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how the geosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere work together to support all living organisms that make up the biosphere. This is our last lesson of this introductory unit. Your next lesson will be a review and assessment of the material we have covered in this unit. Until next time, remember, you're a force of nature, so keep sparking the changes that you want to see. See you next time. Hey, hey.